Windows 11 comes with a lot of settings that are on by default. Most make sense, but there are some annoying ones and some that you probably don't need at all. In this video, I'm going to show you which settings you should probably change right away. These are going to be things that will have an impact on your privacy and improve the overall experience with Windows 11. Let's go. If you're like me and you don't like these crowded areas in the start menu and the jump list, there is an easy way to get rid of this clutter. Right-click on the Windows button and go to Settings. Select Personalization and click on Start. In here, turn off these two options to keep these dialog boxes neat and clean. The other thing you can do in here is to add some shortcuts to the Start menu. Right now, when I click on Start, I have a lot of empty real estate between my profile pic and the power button. You can change that by clicking on Folders. Now you can turn on some shortcuts that you want to have. I'm going to go with Pictures and Videos. And now when I click on Windows, I see these buttons and I can jump directly to any of these places. The next thing you want to do in Windows 11 is to disable these annoying notifications. To do that, right-click on the Windows button and select Settings. On the System tab, select Notifications. Scroll down to the bottom and disable Get Tips and Suggestions When I Use Windows. The other thing you want to turn off right away are the ads that now seem to be everywhere. Promoted apps in the Start menu, suggested content on the Settings page, and even in the search results. To get rid of all these, select Privacy and Security. Here under Windows Permissions, select General and turn off all these options. While we're in the topic of privacy, to keep more of your information to yourself, you can change a variety of settings. You can find most of them in the settings under Privacy and Security. Let's start with speech. Turn off online speech recognition. You can still use voice typing and dictation though. Next, we'll go to inking and typing personalization. When it's turned on, Windows collects unique words like names in a personal dictionary. This may help you type and ink more accurately, but I'm not a fan of that, so I'm going to turn it off. Next is diagnostics and feedback. Turn off optional diagnostic data unless, like me, you're in the Windows Insider program. You can also turn off all the other settings down here. If you want, go ahead and clear all diagnostic data that was already collected with this button. So that's it for this area. Finally, I'm quickly going to go to the activity history and turn off the local activity storage. No need to save that. Next up in privacy and security is app permissions. An app on your computer may require specific access to function properly, like to your physical location, to your camera, microphone, and other devices. Now, that may make sense for some apps, but definitely not for all. So let's change that. Similar to Windows 10, you can manage app permissions by category. It's a long list, and I'm not going to go through the entire thing here, but I recommend that you go through these on your own and decide for yourself which access you want to give to which app. Many of these settings can be disabled altogether or disabled only for specific apps. So for example, location here. You can turn off location services completely, or you leave it on and choose which apps can access your location. I usually have most of these off except for maybe the weather app. It's pretty cold here in Austria, so this way I know how many layers I need to put on. There's a lot of apps out there that you don't want on your computer. So to be on the safe side, you may want to limit where you install your apps from. To do that, open Settings, select Apps, and click on Advanced App Settings. Up here, click on the drop-down to choose where you want to get your apps from. The default is Anywhere, which I don't recommend. Either go with the Microsoft Store or one of the other two options. I'm going to go with the Microsoft Store for now. This way, when you try to install a non-verified third-party app, you're going to get this message. Startup programs load automatically when the system is turned on. But every program that's on the list slows down your boot time and it consumes your computer resources. So this should be your VIP list of apps. To change that, go to Settings, select Apps, and then Startup. Next, let's sort by status so you can see which ones are currently enabled. Okay, so on means these apps load during startup. And it also indicates how much resources an app is going to consume. You especially want to check out the ones with high impact. So just go through the list, and if you find a program that you don't need at startup, just toggle it off. I know a lot of people complain that Microsoft is pushing hard to use a Microsoft account instead of the good old local accounts. Now, I use multiple devices, and I actually enjoy the advantages of automatically syncing my data and my settings between these devices. But of course, this way, Microsoft has greater visibility into what I'm doing, what I'm searching for, and how I'm using my computer. So if you want more privacy and you prefer to keep your data and settings local, then switching to a local account may be an option for you. Here's how you can do that. Open Settings and select Accounts. Click on Your Info. Here in Account Settings, you can see that I'm using my Microsoft account. And over here, you can sign in with a local account instead. Click it and follow the steps in the window that pops up. And no worries, you're not going to lose any local data by switching. Okay, so that's it for today. If this video was useful for you, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. If you also have tips of your own, do share them with us in the comments below. And if you're new to my channel, please subscribe so that we can see each other more often. Many thanks for watching, and I'm going to see you in the next video.